Madame la Chancelière, j'ai l'honneur de vous présenter la professeure Friederike Otto, qui s'est distinguée par son leadership dans la recherche et la communication sur le rôle de l'humanité dans les changements climatiques et par sa quête de justice environnementale. Dr. Otto is a senior lecturer at Imperial College London's Grantham Institute for Climate Change and the Environment. She is also co-founder and lead of World Weather Attribution, an international effort to track and communicate the role that human-induced climate change has on extreme weather events such as droughts, heat waves, and storms. Using deep statistical analysis based on climate models, her small team can rapidly determine how likely it is for such disasters to occur with and without climate change. By providing rigorous evidence quickly, climate change attribution has helped to shift the global conversation, aiding litigation against polluters and influencing adaptation strategies. Although she spends her days examining apocalyptic events, Dr. Otto remains optimistic. Improving institutional and public understanding of humanity's role in extreme weather events will provide a catalyst for investments in social systems. It's a step towards making populations less vulnerable and more resilient. Dr. Otto is the author of the popular science book, Angry Weather, Heat Waves, Floods, Storms, and the New Science of Climate Change, and her writing has been featured in many of the world's leading journalistic publications. In 2021, Dr. Otto was recognized for co-founding World Weather Attribution by Time 100, a list of the world's most influential people, and by the journal Nature as one of the top 10 people who made a difference in science that year. Madame la Chancelière, au nom du Conseil d'administration et du Sénat de l'Université, j'ai le privilège et l'honneur de vous présenter Dr. Friederike Otto afin que vous lui décerniez un doctorat en sciences honoris causa.
I will now ask Dr. Otto to address the audience.
Madam Chancellor, Mr. President and Vice Chancellor, honored guests, graduating class, family and friends, and my amazing sister, I am humbled and really, really grateful to receive this honor. An honorary doctorate is not something you expect, and that's not something that's often given to an academic who has is in the middle of her career. And I'm really proud of this because it's given for me for my research leadership, but also for the role in communication and justice. And that is really why I do my work, why we've founded World Weather Attribution. And so to receive this recognition is really amazing. And it was definitely not something that I expected ever to do when I graduated. I never had a graduation ceremony. So it feels amazing to wear this robe and to actually feel like you've achieved something. So. I mean, please enjoy this. You don't get to do this probably ever again in your life. Just feel proud and enjoy this, that you are here and have achieved something. It's really, really special, and a lot of people don't get the chance ever to do that. In my work, that I, together with a team of amazing people with whom nothing on this scale would be possible, and a lot of whom had no idea what they were going to do when they graduated and then changed career and started to do something different. What we are doing, as Matthew was saying, as Damon was saying, is we look at extreme weather events and figure out what the role of climate change is in these extreme weather events. And we look at events that have turned into disasters. We look at events that are affecting humans, a lot of humans. And what this work shows very, very clearly is that natural disasters don't exist. On the one hand, and this is what originally all this work has been about to show, this is because in a rapidly warming world, due to the burning of fossil fuels, many extreme weather events occurring today are hotter, wetter, longer, and in short, just much worse than they would have otherwise been. However, the emphasis on climate change in the reports on these events have actually led many to believe now that climate change somewhat has replaced acts of God and that human-induced climate change is responsible for the disaster. But actually, throughout my work, we found again and again that severe weather-related hazards that led to the most severe weather-related disasters resulted from existing vulnerabilities, from compounding stresses on social systems. In other words, it is the poor that die in a heat wave and in flooding because they live in badly insulated homes. It is them who pay for the droughts across the world through dramatically increased food prices. It's people from disadvantaged backgrounds that suffer the most when schools are closed again and people can't get an education. It's people in refugee camps and conflict zones across the world who are put on the edge or over the edge and lose everything by the extra degree in an extreme heat, by the longer drought, and by the heavier downpours. So what my work has showed me very clearly is that we really talk about climate change wrong. It's not a physical problem with a technical solution we have to deal with on top of other issues like the cost of living crisis or anything else, but it is a consequence of inequality and of putting profit of the few against the most essential human rights, the rights of life, the rights of housing, the right to education. There is no solution to climate change without increasing inequality. And so in a time like this, in a year like this, this is so much more important than ever it feels in, at least in my career, that we can't play one crisis against the other crisis, but that we have to find coalitions even if they are uncomfortable and if we don't agree 100%, but actually fight what really hurts most people most, and that is inequality, that is growing inequality and the lack of access. And while a lot of the work that I'm doing is on disasters and shows really when everything has gone really, really wrong, it actually also shows that we have a huge amount of agency, all of us, because when lots of things go wrong, you can also do lots of things right, and you can do a lot of things a little bit better. And it doesn't matter what scale you're looking at. You're here as graduates of Concordia, so you already have a bigger platform than a lot of people will ever have. But we all, even if your sphere of influence at the moment feels really, really small, it is quite big. It matters how you talk about the problems and of this world and the things you care about with your friends, with your family, and even if it's uncomfortable, it matters and it changes things if you talk about them. But of course, you have also, a lot of us have and will have much larger spheres of influence. We can run a company or we might have children and they go to a school and you can change things at the school they are going to. And all of these things change things in society. You don't have to be a scientist, you don't have to be the CEO of a big company, you don't have to be a policymaker to make a big change. We all have these spheres of influence. And most people I know that have actually now seem to be people that end up in the Times 100 magazine would never have thought that they have any influence or that they could do something, but have just done it nevertheless. And for me, this honorary doctorate is saying thank you and actually is worth fighting for things, even if it's hard. But I really hope that you all say thank you to yourself when you have small achievements and tell your friends and celebrate yourself, because it's actually not that hard to stay optimistic, even in times that seem really difficult, because we have so much agency, and we that we are all here have so much privilege to change things. And that alone is a huge reason to be optimistic. And so, yeah, for me, this is really a moment to celebrate. And I'm hugely grateful to be here and talk to you and to you all. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Otto. That was really inspiring.